Hello, my friends. As you may or may not know, my background as a professional is internal medicine, endocrinology, and metabolism. And as I took my training a long time ago, what impressed me was that the deeper you go into your biology, the more microscopic it becomes. And then you go deeper into the microscopic nature of the biology, you end up with molecules and then particles and then wave functions and then mathematical abstractions. However, science is an amazing adventure. It allows us to know modes of experience that are not available to the naked eye as a result of our creating instruments that extend the range of our sensory experiences. So we can see things or experience things, better word, that we cannot with our normal sensory processes. And the more we realize this, we start with biochemistry and then biophysics and mathematics, and then everything becomes abstract and invisible. However, an insight I had a long time ago is the smaller an organism or organelle, the smaller things that are not visible to the naked eye have more energy and information packed inside them than seemingly large things. Of course, the large things are made of small things as well. But if you want to go deep into the intelligence of nature, you have to go into smaller and smaller and ultimately the reality that is invisible even to the naked eye. So, as a result of my interest in metabolism, I became interested in biophysics and then now quantum body, etc., etc. And my interest expanded from treating disease to preventing disease to actually optimizing health and well-being through the integration of mind, body, and spirit. And then, as I grew older, biologically and chronologically, although my biological age hasn't caught up with my chronological age, I became interested in health span and longevity, which is a very major interest of mine right now, and also interest of the research education that we do at the Chopra Foundation, which is a non-profit entity and does many things, but amongst them education and literacy around aging and how to slow it down, how to even reverse it. And you might ask, why do we want to live longer in this crazy world with war and terrorism and eco-destruction and social economic injustice and chronic diseases and deep depression? I think the reason to live longer, at least for me, is ultimately to find the source of all experience, fundamental reality, to align with it and to become one with it, which in wisdom traditions is called enlightenment. So longevity for me and health span is for longevity. Okay, so much of the philosophy. So today I want to talk about one of the strategies for healthy aging, and that is understanding the powerhouses of our cells called mitochondria. Remember, anything we give a name to is a mode of knowing and experience, and therefore is a modified form of consciousness. But We can't talk in abstract terms all the time, so we reify means make concrete that which is seemingly abstract. So anyway, mitochondria are often referred to as the powerhouses of the cell because their primary function is to generate energy for our bodies. They're very tiny, very, very tiny sausage-shaped organelles, small organs found in the cells of our body, except for the red blood cells. Because red blood cells do not have a nucleus, and so they're not found in cells. They're found in eukaryotic cells. Eukaryotic cells are cells that have a nucleus which has a membrane, and then these little organelles which all have membranes. So let's go a little bit deeper into the nature, the location, the function of what are called mitochondria. So where are mitochondria found? Mitochondria are found in the cytoplasm of almost all eukaryotic cells, including animal cells, plant cells, fungal cells. The number of mitochondria varies depending on the cell type and its energy needs. Muscle cells, for example, have many more mitochondria than skin cells. The function of mitochondria is that they produce something called ATP, adenosine triphosphate, the main energy currency of cells. And they produce this through a process called aerobic respiration. In other words, the cells in your body are literally breathing. Okay. And as a result of this aerobic respiration, the mitochondria break down sugars, fats, proteins into usable energy through a series of complex chemical reactions. Mitochondria also play a role in cell signaling and cell death because cell death, apoptosis, programmed cellular death, is very important for the body to renew itself. Death is what makes life possible. I've mentioned that in previous videos. So, what else do mitochondria do? They store calcium, important for muscle function and nerve signaling, and they generate heat to maintain body temperature. Can we improve mitochondrial health? Yes, we can. Since mitochondria are crucial for overall health, maintaining their function is important. And so, here are some ways to improve mitochondrial health. One is diet. Consume a healthy diet rich in fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. These nutritious substances provide essential nutrients for mitochondrial function. Limit processed foods, sugary drinks, and unhealthy fats, which can damage mitochondria. Consider foods rich in oxidants, rich in antioxidants like berries, cherries, leafy greens, as they help protect mitochondria from harmful molecules. I'll do another video soon on the miraculous phytochemicals present in, say, cherries and berries at another time. Exercise also increases the number and function of mitochondrial cells. And even if you do 30 minutes of moderate intensity exercise most days of the week, you will increase the function of mitochondrial cells. Sleep. Adequate sleep is essential for cellular repair and regeneration, including mitochondria. So I always aim to 7 to 8 hours of high quality sleep. Now, a lot of people are asking about supplements, and if you have a really healthy diet, which hardly anyone has, then probably you don't need supplements. But as we grow older, the lining of our stomach gets a little less pliable, so micronutrients are not easily absorbed. So I do take supplements like coenzyme Q10, L-carnitine, and alpha-lipoic acid to support mitochondrial function. And this is basically it. Manage stress and avoid smoking, avoid alcohol as much as you can, and follow everything I've said, and you will have increased energy at a cellular level. And since I'm now on the road talking about longevity and health span, I'll keep sharing some ideas with you, including all the strategies for maximizing health span. I hope you enjoy this, and let me know if I should continue this little bit of education on health span longevity. The most important of which I have not mentioned, and that is something to do with consciousness, but more on that later.